team is everything. But today video, my friends, we talk about how to build a team. Welcome everyone. Sergio San back. Today's subject very good, very interesting subject. You can apply in your management, at your work, at your project, at your operation. What we are saying, team is first. Team is everything. But today video, my friends, we talk about how to build a team. Project management wise, because project management, some temporary team come together and they deliver something and they release, they dismiss from the project. So how we can create team, but not good team, dream team. So this subject related PMP exam, exam content outline task, task name is build a team under the people domain. Project management staff, staff who perform the work, third party experts, users or customers, representatives, seller, supplier, business partners, we don't separate any of them. We are all together project team. Maybe you make internal projects, all the team is internal resources. Maybe you work business project, customer projects, supplier, customers, your company, everybody involved. So all we are team. My friends, first of all, we will do resource management plan. Resource management plan, there are two parts at resource management plan. First part, roles and responsibilities. Roles, authority, responsibility, assigned duties, competence, skills, spreadsheets, roles, race, responsibility, accountability, consultant, inform, simple race chart, and assign activities to that people. Agile. Agile way, there is no assignment. Team is self-organizing, self-managing team. No need any task assignment. Skill set, very important. Spreadsheets, assess your team members. There is a but here, team is first. But unskillful team is not okay for us. We need skilled people. We need SME. What is SME? Subject matter experts. There are limited at your company such kind of people. We can say subject matter zero. Junior people don't agree with me. Less experienced people don't agree with me. Yes, you will learn, you will make projects, but difficult task we cannot assign to you. We need subject matter experts in our project and very difficult to reach them. As a project manager, as a line manager, as an operation manager, you should find those, but accessing, reaching them a bit difficult because everybody wants them to work. So make skill spreadsheet in your projects. What skills you need to do activities, people name and their certification, their experience related this area. Assess them, some assessments we need to do. So project organization chart, relationship chart, reporting relationship. So we need project organization chart. If we are doing a team, who is leader, who is worker, who is executors, how to staff, manage and release team, you should write inside resource management plan. Training plan, very important. During the project, allocate budget for that. Train your people. You need trainings during project. Rewards plan, recognition plan. Another, when you calculate your project budget, don't forget rewards plan. Give rewards. When we can give rewards, execution or closure, after you finish the project, you can give, no, not closure. Any milestone reach, any activity completed, you can give rewards. During execution, please give during execution, make reward plan. Any rewards can be monetary or even some free dinner, or some check, some gift coupon to your team members, or recognition free, recognize your people in the middle of everyone. This is free. Don't forget to make your budget. Start by aligning right skills to the right part of the project. More senior, experienced talent will help you to do more work in less time. Allow less experienced people. Please, junior people, less experienced people, don't be sad for that. Allow less experienced people to work on low-risk tasks. Will help those people grow and learn. Don't give less experienced people very critical task, very critical part of the project. They will be stressful and they cannot learn. However, tasks may take longer to complete if you assign them. No problem, we will teach them also. How to create team? Begin thinking of individual who could get those jobs done in your organization. Just you start project, okay, you need to establish team activities, who can do those activities. Think of that. Sorry, document each person qualifications and expertise level of experience and proficiency. Make spreadsheets. John, Java expert, 3 years experience, certifications, what is the evidence of this Java? Melanie is UI expert, 7 years. What kind of certification she has? So such kind of spreadsheet please prepare. Document each person qualification, we said. Check with functional manager. This is the challenging part. They have functional manager. You want them to your projects, but they are busy maybe. Negotiate with functional manager. Good luck with that one. If you can't get them, John not available, Melanie not available, what you will do? You have other people, junior people, less experienced people. What you can do? 2 things. Train them, junior people, because we don't have Java experts, some junior people, you can train them, but you have no time for training. Training is not quickly transform them to be expert. What you will do? The second option, outsource. You can hire that resource from outsource partner as a temporarily. This is assessment method. How you assess them? Other methods also, like specific assessment, specific assignment. Give them some tasks before hiring them. Interview, personal interview with them. Ability skills test. Most of HR departments before hiring new people, they are doing ability skills skill test. And check their recognized certification. Honestly speaking, if someone don't have project management certification or business analyst certification or other certification, globally recognized institutes, I don't want to give any position for that people. Maybe they are experienced, but recognized certified people one step further than others. So I check always their certification and validity of these certifications important. Now, tips. Avoid single point of failures, my friends. In your project, one person know everything, not knowledge transfer to other people. These people left the company, left the project. What will happen? Who will do this task? Don't create hero in your projects. Evaluate. Second tip. Evaluate technical and interpersonal skills, both 50%, 50%. Technically, some person good, but relations with others, relations with customer, relations with management, interpersonal, soft skills. When you evaluate people, 50% evaluate technical skills, 50% evaluate interpersonal, soft skills, relations with others. Another consideration, tip three, Considered when assigning responsibilities. Consider time zone. Consider location. Consider communication needs. So how to manage them is very effective here. If in the beginning you assess wrong people, wrong skills in your projects, you cannot manage their conflicts. Their conflicts because of lack of technical knowledge, maybe. Lack of soft skills. Conflict. How to motivate them? You can set ground rules. Next video I will talk about ground rules. Co-location. Co-location, gather them same location like agile team. Remote work not possible. Complex projects, make them to be same location. These are techniques how to manage them. Team building activities. Team buildings make them more close to each other and more open each other and more trusting each other. Even virtual team, you have virtual team, my suggestion, recommendation to you, meet them once in same location. After that everybody can go their countries, their location. But if you start the project remote, everybody remote, you cannot build a trust. People don't trust. Still video camera or video connection, they don't trust each other. But first meeting, two meeting, same location. After that they can go their homes, home countries. Difficult to manage also virtual team. But virtual team important because expert people you can reach easily. But how to manage them? Communication plan. Another video I will talk about how to manage virtual teams. The most important thing, good communication plan and technology. Agile team, number four, tip four. Agile team, no assignments. Agile team, self-managing team, self-organizing team. Agile team, they are doing their self, they choose what they will do. There is no hero in agile team. One task, one requirements below belong to everyone. If one person fail, everybody fail. So agile team, no need assignment. So what we are saying, team is first, but great team is important. A great team created by project managers and leaders. And enjoy to create your great team. Thank you for watching my video. See you next video. Bye bye.